Hi fellow travelers, this is Ken and welcome to my channel, Ken Travels 360. After the exciting embarkation day yesterday for a Royal Caribbean cruise on Symphony of the Seas, we've now got 2 days at sea before we reach our first port, St. Martin. In this video, I will show you all the fun ship activities we'll participate in. Last night, we stayed up late for the balloon dropping party at midnight. So this morning, we woke up rather late and quite hungry as well. We headed to the main dining room to have brunch. The menu was exactly the same as the brunch menu on Anthem of the Seas last year, so I'm not gonna delve into that in this video. Afterwards, it's time for Flowrider. I tried that last year on Anthem of the Seas. You can watch it by clicking the link above. Today, I gave it a couple of tries. The first time, I was really just reacquainting myself with how it all works. On my second go, I was really determined to get to the stage where I get my knees up onto the boogie board. My first few attempts ended up in failure and mostly wiped out. The instructor did teach me what I needed to do. But whether one could actually physically execute it is another matter. If you have done Flowrider, let me know in the comments below how long it took you to learn. I was so happy to finally get my knees up the boogie board, even for just a few seconds. It's a start, and I know how easy others make it look like this kid after me, but I don't care. You can't really compare yourself to others. Okay, let's keep the adrenaline going. After Flowrider, let's try the zip line. So I just did the zip line because I've done the Go A a few months ago. It was nowhere as scary as that. I just did it. I didn't scream or anything, but it was really fun.
Next, I'm gonna try the ultimate abyss. It's a dry slide that takes you down from the slide's glass platform on deck 16 down 10 decks to the boardwalk. From this glass platform, you can see all the way down. Unfortunately, all loose items like cameras have to be stowed away. So I will show you Royal Caribbean's stock footage instead.
That's the ultimate abyss that I just slid down. It wasn't scary at all. So we're here at Johnny Rockets. If you have a deluxe drinks package, then you can get your milkshake free here. So here is, my milkshake.
After having my Oreo milkshake, which by the way I thoroughly recommend, we play a bit of mini golf on Symphony June, which is the miniature golf course.
So we're gonna try some mini golf. It's the middle of the afternoon on the first day. It looks quite fun.
After a while, we got bored and it was time to go to the Royal Theatre to watch the Broadway show Hairspray.
Thank you.
finished watching the Hairspray musical. It was really interesting. I've never heard of it before coming onto this ship, but it was really good. Right, it's time for dinner now. Let's go there.
Tonight is French night, and this is the menu. As for me, I've ordered escargot again. For dinner, tonight we have beef tenderloin. It's served with a couple of asparagus tips as well. So for dessert, we've got creme brulee. So I just ordered the next cocktail. This is a chocolate martini. Tastes very nice. Cocktail in hand, we headed to Studio B for the second show today. It's the show 1977, a spectacular adventure on the ice skating rink.
So we just finished watching the Ice Dance Show 1977. It was absolutely brilliant, really, really good. We just got back to our room and there is a beautiful tile animal that has been done for us. It's an elephant.
Good morning. Today is day 3 of our Royal Caribbean cruise on Symphony of the Seas. We're waking up to a serene azure ocean stretching out to a clear blue sky. These are the moments that make me grateful for my balcony room. As the weather is magnificent today, many cruisers are out on the pool deck and a lot of sun lounges are already occupied or reserved.
So today we are going to have breakfast at Solarium Bistro. It's much less crowded than Windjammer normally. But today we are quite late. We have to wait. Let's see what they have at Solarium Bistro for breakfast. They have bread. There's your traditional English or American breakfast items. Sausages, beans, eggs, hash browns. It's repeated on the other sides with tomatoes, boiled eggs and bacon. And lots of pastry here. And yogurt. Over here you have an egg station with omelette and fried eggs. And they've got all sorts of pancakes. If you are looking for something more healthy, there are cheese, cold cuts, and fruits, as well as a parfait. I tried this smoked salmon with ink. It's actually very delicious. Here are the fruits.
After breakfast, we headed down to Royal Promenade.
On the Royal Promenade, there are some really funky art. Here, this is a car that is scorched into a ball. Over here, we have the next cruise. If you book your next cruise while you are here, you get $100 on board credit. Before the cruise, I actually already have an idea what I want for the next cruise. So I took advantage of the deal to book here.
Next, it's time to try the carousel again.
I'm on a very tall horse. It's a little bit scary.
After the carousel, we rushed back to Royal Promenade as the Anchors Away parade was just underway.
Anchors Away, Anchors Away, Anchors Away.
After the parade, we spent a good part of the afternoon sunbathing on the pool deck. At around 2:30, I got down to deck 4 to wait at Studio B for the ice skating ticket.
As you can see, there's a very long line signing up for the ice skating. I was here before anyone, so I was able to get whatever session I wanted, which was great. I did come here 25 minutes before though.
After some more sunbathing, it's finally time to try ice skating. I've never done ice skating before, so understandably, I was very nervous and holding onto the rail all the time initially.
Hello.
Hello.
My hope is that by the end of the session, I will be able to skate around without holding onto the rail all the time. After a while, I gained some confidence and I was able to start letting go of the rail while skating next to it, knowing that I have something to fall back on.
Do you see that?
Yep.
Whoa. Oh, it's quite fun.
You're doing well.
Scary.
I was starting to make some progress when they announced that our session was finishing soon. However, as there were not enough punters in the next session, they allowed everyone to just continue skating till the end if they would like to do so.
I won't say I got it, but...
You've got more of it than you started with.
The extra practice time definitely helped. I think without it, I wouldn't have made enough progress and I would probably never try it again. Instead, I was pleased with my progress today and I was looking forward to try this again later on the same cruise. After the ice skating, we're gonna check out the sunset before going for dinner. The sunset is just absolutely stunning.
If you enjoy watching this video, please give me a thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel with notifications enabled. That way, you'll be notified whenever I release a new video.
Thank you. The bar lady has made a really nice chocolate martini for me.
Alright, this is day 3 and we have Italian night tonight. There's some chef recommendation. Italian minestrone, lasagna al forno and tiramisu. So today, the theme is Italian. And Steve has got the carpaccio, beef carpaccio as starter. For me, I actually ordered something from the main course as the starter. It's the mushroom risotto with truffles. But in my defense, in Italy, it's really acceptable to have risotto as the primi piatti. So for main course, Steve was keen to avoid tomato-based dinner. And he ordered chicken parmesan. And that for me, to be on the safe side, I ordered the New York strip steak, no tomato in sight. So our dessert has arrived. It's tiramisu, a classic Italian dessert. After dinner, we went to the top deck. Because we have no show to watch tonight, we wanted to relax a bit in the jacuzzi in the solarium. At night, the sculpture Big Wonder becomes beautifully lit. So as you can see, in the evening, the jacuzzi is a lot quieter. We're gonna go in now. After the jacuzzi, it's time to get another drink. This time from Bionic Bar.
Yeah, you can't see that. I'm gonna try a Captain Cuba Libre. It's free because I've got the deluxe drink package. All the scent.
So the robot on the right is making my drink now. This is really cool. The robot is pouring my drink. Whoa! It's finished. Now I have to tap my key card here to get my drink.
Voila!
It's a rising tide and we're gonna go in.
Welcome!
So right now we are in the rising tide. This is a very interesting bar that is actually basically an elevator. It goes up from deck 5, the Royal Promenade, up to deck 8, Central Park. And we're gonna try it out. So the door has been closed, so we should be getting up soon. We're moving up now. So this ride takes about 3 minutes to get from the deck 5 to deck 8. So we have got up to deck 6 now, and behind us is a Shuna Bar. It's a very fun little gimmick. So it departs every half an hour. So if you time your entry, you get to ride this up or down.
This is Central Park at night. Every night, they put a piano in one of the lifts, and a pianist inside will be playing music. I just caught one being set up. Anyway, it's karaoke time next. The evening is still not over yet, as we went to the adults-only Big Wonder White Attire party in the Solarium.
So I wasn't sure what drink I should have next, and I just say I want something with Quantro, and they made a margarita for me.
We didn't party for too long, as tomorrow we will have our first port, St. Martin. But what a night this has been. Thanks for watching this video. If you are interested in watching more of this cruise, just click one of the links on the screen now. I'll see you over there.